Just making sure I am live. Just making sure I am live. Just let me. Okay, I think we're live. I think we're good to go. Hope everybody can hear me okay. Hi, Sylvia. Right, I'm back. I'm actually back. Hi, Sylvia. Lovely to see you. Now, sorry I haven't been around for the last few weeks, but unfortunately we caught COVID. We're not quite 100%, but we're nearly there, so we're... It's good to be feeling normal again. So, what have we missed in the last few weeks? I have a little bit of housekeeping, just to go through quickly with you. So, on the 2nd of November, Stampin' Up! Released a suite or a bundle. It is a suite, but... they released it early. This will be in the January to June mini catalogue next year. And they've released it early. So it's available. This is available from the 2nd of November to the 3rd of January. Not everything in this early release is going to be in the January to June catalogue, so it will just be the actual bundle itself, so the stamp and the die set. They have got some beautiful it's called Ever Eden designer series paper. They have some Ever Eden cotton paper, which is unusual, very nice. They've got some lovely garden gems. And this comes as a suite at the moment, and this is available, as I say, up to the 3rd of January. And after the 3rd of January, it will only be the bundle, which is the stamp and the die set. You'll not be able to get any of the other things, but that is it's really nice. I haven't got it to demonstrate, but it is really lovely. I've seen a lot of demonstrations with it, and it's very versatile. Can be used Christmassy, can be used birthday, anniversary. It is lovely. So the suite, or should I say the collection, is £77.50. So that is everything that you see there. The bundle, which is just the stamp and the die set, is £49.50. And then I say you can buy the other bits, your designer series paper, your cotton paper, and your gems as well. But if you didn't want everything, you could just have the designer series paper. So that's £77.50. So I've just got a couple of bits to show you. So you can make some really nice. It's all the greens, it looks like. Very nice, it is very nice. So that's Eden's Garden. Not only have we Eden's Garden, we have a wonderful startup offer. So if you are a hobby, if you have your craft as your hobby, or you want to start a crafty business, you can join Stampin' Up for £75, and you can get £130 worth of product, which is brilliant. It's usually £99 to start, and so at the moment it's like you can get Eden's Garden for £77.50, but obviously you'll have postage on that. But for £75, and this is till the 30th of November, this offer for the startup. You get £130 worth of stuff, and you don't have to pay any postage on your startup pack. So you can get that extra, £55 in goodies. So you could get the actual collection of the Eden's Garden and other things. So it's a really, really good offer. So if anybody doesn't have if they don't have a demonstrator and they want to become one, there you go. That's what you need to do. And that's you can do that by visiting my contacting me, lorna.carter@stampinup.net. You can find me, I'm Lorna Carter's Creations on Facebook and on Instagram. And you can actually find me also, Lorna Carter's Creations, on YouTube. So that's a couple of things. Another thing is from the 16th, which is tomorrow, till the 18th of November, we have a sale. Now I have to apologise, because my brain has just totally gone, but you're getting discounts. Dyes are 20%, I do know. And there's discounts off cardstock and inks. But unfortunately, I'm sorry, I just cannot remember what percentage it is off cardstock and ink. One's 10%, I think, and one's 15%, and I can't remember which way round. But the dyes is definitely 20%. So that's 16th to the 18th of November. So if anybody out there hasn't got a demonstrator and would like to purchase anything, please get in touch and we'll have a talk. And I say visit lorna.carter@stampinup.net. Right, I think that's majority of things out of the way. Sorry, it's because I've not been around for a few weeks. Over the weekend, I was lucky enough to attend, it's for demonstrators only, what they call an on-stage event. But unfortunately, it wasn't an in-person event, it was all done virtually. But we had some good fun. We saw the new mini catalogue that's coming out in January. Saw some of the products being demonstrated. And it was really good fun. It was a really nice time. It's the first one I've done, so it was an experience, but I'll certainly be doing it again. And what we did, we had a time where we could create some cards. They released another, we could buy another bundle, which we could use for those cards. But I wanted to wait and see what was actually in the catalogue before I decided what I wanted. So these cards I'm going to show you, these are what I've just made with the products that we've got. And so that's a thank you card. That's like a notelet size, that one. And then we've got this one. Rest and relax, you deserve it. And this is this designer series paper. This is something I've created. And it's a sneak peek of what I'm going to be showing you in the weeks to come. So that's another one. And then the final one is the happy birthday. So that's using, I think it's Nature's Harvest, if I remember rightly, out the mini catalogue at the moment. So that's that one. And then the other cards I've just got to show you, if I can find them. What have I done with them? There you go. So these are, thanks Sylvia. So these are a couple of swaps. This is the swap. I made one for myself as well as the other ladies that attended. Thanks Izzy, 10% off card and 15% off ink. Yeah, and it was 20% off dyes. Yeah, and it's on for a couple of days. Brilliant. Thank you for that, Izzy. So this is the swap I made for the ladies. This is the bay window fold that we're going to be making tonight. I'm going to do a Christmas one tonight. It's slightly different. But I made this, and I made it, these are actually if I can just take it off, they're actually paper clips. And this is made with the Hand Pens Designer Series paper. So I've got that and then a little bag as well. I don't know if you can zoom in on that or not. But that's those. Just something totally different. And I'll just pop them. I'll pop them back in a bit. So that was the swap I made. I did for the ladies, and this is one of the swaps I got in return. This is made by Izzy. Thank you very much, Izzy. It's a lovely stamp set. This is a new one that's coming out in the January to June mini catalogue this next year. So that's that one. Okay, right. Now we've got everything all gone through, I think. I don't think I've forgotten anything. This is what we're going to be making. This is a bay window fold card. So I've made this as if it's a front door of a house with a wreath on. And then I've just left it blank inside, to be honest. You can either put a sentiment in there, write in there, or you could either do it on the back. But I haven't, I've just left it blank. But this is what we're going to be creating. So I'm quite excited, quite looking forward to it because I love it. I have done a lot of preparation because I didn't want to be on too long tonight because it's my first day properly back at work, and I have been very tired. So I've cut a lot of the card and everything, but I've got all the dimensions. So that's what we're going to be making. So if I put that to one side, right, just find me, I put everything over here, and is that the right one? That is the right one. Right, okay, so I've got half a piece of A4 basic white thick on here, and cut it lengthways. So we've got 29.6, something like that. 29.6, I think it is. And it's 10.5 deep. And just let me get my measurements. So I've already scored it, but I'm just going to go through. Just going to go through where we score and how we score this, because. Because we are, let me just show you on the card. These are like mountain folds, but this is a valley fold. I don't know if you can. So I'm going to turn the card stock over as we score, so we get a nicer crease. So here we go. So in we go with the card, and we're going to score at 0.9 centimetres. So you'd score in there. I've already done it, so I'm not going to do it. But then we're going to turn the card over, and we're going to score at 5.2 centimetres. So we'll do that, score at 5.2. We're now going to score at 9.6 centimetres. All these measurements will be all on the YouTube in the description. So if you don't get a chance to write them down. So we're going to score at 9.6. So then we're going to go in, we're going to turn it over, and we're going to score at 13.9. So then we score again, and then back over, we're going to score at 14.8, like so, which is the halfway mark. So that's 0.9 centimetres, 5.2 centimetres, 9.6 centimetres, 13.9 centimetres, and 14.8. That is all the scoring for the base card. So I'm going to pop that away. Get my bone folder. And we're going to, just trying to see, we're going to burnish all our score lines. Okay, so that is your normal half a card. So the next fold, we're going to come back on itself. Okay, so then we've got, it's a little bit like that book binding fold. You've got that little piece down there. We've just got that little piece. We're going to stick that down, but it's very, very similar to how that works. So then the next two score lines, we're going to fold the opposite way. Like so. And then the last one, we're going to fold back on itself. So this is what we get. So that's what we're going to do. So that's all the scoring. Put my bone folder away. Now I'm already prepared. I've got my little tub with all my pre-cuts. I've got all my dimensions written down, so I can go through them with you. Right, so the designer series paper I'm using tonight is in good taste. It's in the annual catalogue. Just let me quickly flick through. It's quite a nice one. It's like got some wood effect. There's hexagons, brick effect, knitted effect, wood, paint, oh, I don't know, paint, artexy type to me, that. We've got a lovely blue tiled. This is the one, we're going to be using. The miniature bricks, more wood. It's lovely, it's really nice, it's great masculine cards. Absolutely fabulous. Just all lovely designs. And you get, it's a good selection, because you get, I can't remember how many sheets you get, 20, 24, I'll tell you in a minute. So that is all the things. 24 sheets you get. It's a good size, it's lovely. So that's what we're using, and I thought, obviously, I wanted a brick for the outside of a house. So this is what we've got. So I'll quickly run through the measurements. So we have DSP. We have two little panels, the fine panels. 0.7 centimetres by 10 centimetres. And then we need three of the bigger panels, which are 10 centimetres by 4 centimetres. So that is for the front of the card. And I realise I've got to do some cutting, because I've realised I've missed a piece off. That's my brain. Oh dear, brain fog or what? Right, so I'm just going to stick these down. I'm just going to sit down. So, I'm just doing it with wet glue. And so I'm going to do it that way. Gonna stick that onto there. Right, on that piece and that piece, we're going to do some die cutting, so you need to make sure that that is stuck down really well. So I'm going to do it, that's the right way. So just line that up. Make sure that's stuck down. The middle one's not so bad because we're putting a door on there. So that one. Goes like that. This is the end one, one of the largest end, which needs to be plenty on. Right. And then the end piece. Just a small bead. And then there we go. It's sticky. I've got to change the paper on here. It's a little bit sticky still. Okay, so that is what we've got so far. I'm just going to leave that to one side to let it dry. I'm just going to put that up there, and what I'm going to do, we're going to put the door together and put the wreath together. So the door is real red cardstock, and it is 3.5 centimeters by 8.5 centimeters. And then we have, just get them out, we have four little pieces. I've just got to find them in my tub. That's it. So we have four little pieces, and they are 1.3 centimeters by 3.6 centimeters. So what we're going to do, just going to, sometimes when you just had to replace my blade on my trimmer, I just wanted to, sometimes you get a ridge, so I'm just making sure. So we're going to stick these like so. So let's get some glue on them. So I'm using the wet glue, and you just need to leave a little border just round the edge. And line that one up. Like so. Top two, and we're just going to leave a little gap in the middle. We're still going to leave an edge round. cat hair again. I've had the cats in with me tonight. Right, in my little pot, I have a tiny little piece of, you only want a little slither of gold cardstock, which is for the letterbox. So you just need a little bit. Oops. When I want a little, I always end up with a lot. So I'm going to have that. Like so. And you might get some glue coming around. Never mind. And then I have punched just with a hole punch. I don't know if you can see, a tiny little gold dot. That's going to be the door handle. So, or it can be an off cut from a die, it can be anything. Too much glue again. I'm terrible. So, that is what we've got so far. A little door. So, to make the wreath, I'm going to show you how to do it. I have made one, but I'm going to show you how to do it because there's just something else I want to show you as well. So, you can use dies for these. I've got punches. I'm afraid it's a retired punch because they haven't got any circle punches at the moment. It's Stampin Up. They don't, they're not in the catalogue. So I need some Mossy Meadow. I've used cardstock. So I've got some Mossy Meadow. This is an inch punch. And we're just going to pop that out there. And what I'm going to do, get a pen, I'm going to mark roughly the centre, roughly, and I'm going to get my other punch, and this is where I should have used stuck a piece of card to hold it, but we can manage. And I'm aiming to get that little dot. Just bear with me, let me get my tweezers. More or less. There we go. Not far off. More or less in the middle. And we're going to punch. Hi Shaz, you alright? Lovely to see you. So we've got, can get rid of that little piece, that's going, and we're keeping this one. It's only tiny, it's a bit fiddly, but it looks quite effective. So I want these little I don't know what you call them, leaves, twigs, whatever. These are from, there's four of these in the it is Forever Flourishing dies, and there's four little leaves, tiny ones, and that's what I've die cut these out with. You could use any foliage and cut it up. That's what I've used, and I've just cut the ends off so we haven't got that long end. So what I'm gonna do, I think 7 or 8 of them it takes. So I'm just going to dab a little bit of glue down the leaf. And then I know what I ought to do. Just let me see if I can find it. And it's always the same. I had it last night. My little silicon mat. And you know what? I found it. I didn't think I could find it. So I've got my little silicon mat. So we're going to stick these leaves around this ring. I was racking my brains when I was designing it, what I could use to make a little wreath. So we're just going to overlap and just stick them down. Just wrecking joint. I do it frequently. So just, well, because I haven't been very well, I haven't had my nails done and they're that long. I can't pick anything up. So just a dab, and just keep going round. You will stay. There we go, and just keep going until you're happy with the how it turns out. So nearly there, I'm just going to put a couple more on. So like that. And then one more on. Stuck together. Put them back in my little pot. We only need one bow, so that can go in there. So we'll just Shaz, it's been terrible. I've been off work, well, 3.5 weeks, something like that. I've been doing bits and bobs, but oh, crikey. It's really knocked us for six. It's horrible. I hope your hubby gets better soon. Okay. So, I'm happy with my little wreath. I've got this tiny weeny little bow. And that bow is from... this is from the baby clothes dies, and it's this tiny little one here. Can use it. It's amazing how you can use different things. You find different things to be use them for. Well, that's, I've die cut it out in gold, and then I've just punched a gold, just with me little punch thing, a tiny little, it's a scrap really, of gold to make it look like the knot. So we're going to stick that on. Just thought it was look quite good. So that onto there, and to finish the wreath off, we've got to have some bling. So we're going to put a some of the red rhinestone basic jewels on. So we're going to put five on. Oh, it's got to be an odd number. My fingers are sticky because of the glue. So that's those. So I'm going to pick it up with me. Here's a little, I don't know if it's going to focus. Is it going to focus? Or is it focusing? Ah, that's maybe better. So that is the little wreath that we're going to put on the door. Oh, I hope he gets better soon, Chaz. It's hard work when you're a farmer. I work, they're working for an agricultural dealership, and I know how busy farmers are. They never stop. So I'm gonna just glue that like so. So that is the door then all prepared. I haven't popped it up on dimensionals. I am just basically gluing it flat. So, a bit too much glue on again, look. That's me at the minute. I get it everywhere. So I'll pop that. That is the door already done, ready to be popped on. It's dead, at least ever so cute, dead dinky. I love it. Right, so next I'm going to bring in, I know it's a bit big, but I can't do it on my mini one. We're going to do some die cutting. So my plates. Okay, right, so what I'm using, the die cuts I'm using, or should I say the dies I'm using, are they called the tailor-made tag dies, and this is them. They're fabulous for Christmas and for tags, and for putting tags on cards and all sorts. You find all sorts of uses for them. Like I was with this, I didn't know what I was going to use. I didn't have any, I haven't got the rectangular dies, and I suddenly thought, oh, that could be like an archway, an arch window. So that's the one we're using, which is the third one down, third size down. And I'm just going to hang, don't know if you can pull that forward. I'm just going to hang the edge of the card off the platform. I'm going to use my low tack tape as well. So we're going to go in somewhere. Quite happy with that. So I'll pop that on. Oops. Just going to wind it through and wind it back. Okay. So I've got that stuck to that now. Just pull that off there gently. So we've now got a window. Now I'm just being very careful with this, because don't get rid of this, you keep it, and I'll show you what I did with it after I've made this. And then we do the same for the other side. I always find, just get rid of that. Yes. Always find a use for your waste. Don't like to get rid of anything. If I can use it, I will. So line that up, hopefully somewhere like that. Just put my tape on it, and it's gone on the wonk. So, oops, wrecking everything. Says it all for me, I tell you. I've done it again. Right, so I'm just going to run it through and back. I think, oh no, I can use my mini die cutting machine for the next. Take the plates off. Okay, so we'll pull that off there. So now we've got two windows. Let's see, I'll just take that off, just take it off with care, because I'm going to show you what we do with it. There we go. Just pop me. That's it. I'll pop that in the pot so I don't forget. Right. So we've now got our die cut windows. I knew I'd got a mark on the back. Never mind. So to get the effect of the windows, I've used vellum. Now, the vellum is, just trying to, it's 4.2 centimetres by 8 centimetres. And what I'm going to put that down with, I'm going to use some glue dots for this. So I'm going to put one in each corner. Just put that on there out of the way. So I'm going to get my take your pick tool, and we're going to put, you might not be able to see this very well, I wonder if I put me, there we go, that's better. So one in each corner. They're very sticky because it's really warm in here. Stuck to me now. Actually, I might be better. That's better. I'm better with my tweezers. That's easier for me. Yeah, it must be so warm in here. It is quite warm. Because these are mega, mega sticky. If you find your glue dots are cold, if it's cool in your room, all you need to do, right, find your glue dot, put your finger on it, press it, give it a bit of warmth, and it will become sticky, or should I say stickier. So that's a glue dot in each corner of the vellum. Okay, so we bring our card back. And then I'm going to just make sure not quite
No, it's just sticking over. Oh, it'll be fine. It will be fine. I could throttle myself for getting this mucky. Never mind, it's because my thing needs changing. So, we need to get it. Just making sure of that. That's it. Just keeping it in the score lines. So, this is what we've got now. Right, so for the curtains, so if I just bring that, for the curtains, I've just cut some cardstock. I turn it over. I've just cut some cardstock and I've glued it at the top, a tiny bit down the side and at the bottom, because this goes to show you what not to do. I thought I'd do it with tape and then I realised it was going to show. I didn't quite get it in close enough. So that's not what to do. That side came out better once I'd realised. So all you've got to do, I cut four pieces of real red cardstock and these are, just let me think, what were they? So they were the 9 centimetres by 1.5, sorry, by 1.5 centimetres. So I've cut four, and then on one of them, just move it down so you can see, on one of them, I've just got a pencil, and I've just done me, it should be that way, I've just done my curtain line, and then I've taken that to my next one, I just put it on sort of like that. And then I've just got a pencil and marked all of them and then cut them out. So that's how I've made those. So we should have one for that side. Just making sure one for that side. And then for that side. Right. So let's see if I can get it right this time. Okay, I might actually use glue dots top and bottom. I think that might be good. Let's go in with the glue dots. So if I move the window out the way. So I'm just going to put rid of that, yeah, top. Let's have a look at this, see if this works. So top and bottom, keeping it in line with the, there we go. And there we go. So that works all right. If you do it that bit longer and put a glue dot top and bottom, you won't get the markings like I did with the tape on the other one. So I need to do top, bottom. You just got to make sure you, mind you, curtains are curtains, aren't they? They might not be the same one side to the other. There we go. Yep. No, one's a bit further out than the other, but that's fine.
I'm happy with that. And then we just do the same with these. Oops. Don't stick to me. Top and bottom. They really are. I can't believe how. They're really sticky. They are really, really sticky. That's come off of me. On my finger. Oh, I'll put that one in the bin. Try again. There's me sat here with the body warmer on. Right. So. Like that. And then, like so. Just making sure I put them on the right side, because my brain at the minute is everywhere and anywhere. There we go. So if we come in. Somewhere like so. Just move those out of the way. So there we go. We've got curtains in both rooms. So we're going all right. We're going all right. Okay. So we need to fix the door. I'm going to have the door about there because I've got a step to go on the bottom. Just let me find my... I've got two sills for the window. Already prepared. So this is just the opposite side of the designer series paper I've used for this. I thought it was great. It's a stone colour and it could be the step. So maybe could have done it a bit bigger, but never mind. Okay. Right. So I've raised these up. I've just got three little mini dimensionals on. Just so it just gives it that little bit of dimension. So I'll pop that in the bottom. I'm gonna put, so this, I'm meant to give you the size, so the size so the doorstep is roughly 4.2 centimetres by 0.9 centimetres. You can make it as tall as you want, doesn't matter. But I've also done the same for the windows. I just thought that looked quite sweet. So these are a little bit smaller. So the windowsill is 3.7 centimetres by 0.7, so they're just a little bit narrower then. They're not as deep as the step. But you can make it, say this is what I've done, make it to however you want it. So that. Oops. Go somewhere like that. I'll just take, my nails have got too long now. I'm going next week, can't wait to get them done. Right, I'm just going to stand up for this one, see if we can line her up. Something like that.
So you could always do this card. You could do have a little pot with flowers at the bottom, you know, underneath the windowsill or whatever. Or even have a window. What do you call a windowsill pot? A long one, and have some flowers. Could do it for summer. Can be for every season. You could do it in autumn with an autumnal wreath on. Because all sorts you can do with it. So I'm just gonna stick this in the middle for diddle, hopefully. Okay. So we've got, that's everything on the front. Window box, Chris. That's it. That's what I meant to say. I can't remember. Oh, I'll tell you, brain. Oh, dear. Right, so now what I'm going to do is this narrow piece at the side, we're going to stick down. So I'm just going to put some glue on this narrow. You could use glue. You could use tearing tape. But I've used glue on all mine. So I'm just going to fold it down and just put a little bit of pressure on because it's so narrow. And then the bits I've forgotten to do, I will cut those next. There we go. So that then should just open like so. And it does. Right. So what we need to do next is I'll bring me, I haven't forgotten to cut these pieces out. So we'll do that. That is the only bit of stamping I'm doing tonight. The Merry Christmas. Right, so we need some basic white. Where's my, that's not it. I've got some cardstock. So basic white, and we need some of the, just wondering, no, that's too small, that was an off cut. Thank you, Chris. Right, so trimmer out. So we need, let me find our measurements. So we need a piece of a basic white. I'm actually using a cut off of the thick, but you can use basic, just the standard. 4.5 centimetres by 10.5. And I think that's 10.5 it is. So did I say 4.5? I'll do that side, 4.5. So we'll just cut that bit, and then of the designer series paper we need, my brain's gone, where is it, 4 centimeters by 10. So I'm gonna cut a piece of at 10. Put that to one side. Right, so I said 4 centimeters. That's it.
So out of the, just to give you an idea, out of the two cards I've made with this designer series paper, these are 12 by 12. I've got that piece, I've nearly got, what, two thirds of it left, enough to make some more. I think I'll be making some more of these to sell them. Right, so I need to pop that on there. That's 10.5, not 10. They both need to be 10.5, sorry. 10.5. They both need to be 10 tall, not 10.5. Oh, brain. I want it to be the same height of the panel. I'm just going to cut a tad off that bit. The same height, but I just want the width to be 0.5 centimetre different. So we've got some white showing either side. Okay, so glue that down. And we'll go with a bit at the bottom. So it will go right down to the bottom of this and up to the top, but you'll just have that white showing at the side. I've got it on level. There we go, just put my palm folder down that. There we are. Okay, so what we're going to do is, this is going to go up on dimensionals. It's going to go just about, not quite to the edge, but just so you've got a little space all the way around. And because, I'll show you on this card, this lip, this narrow lip, locks behind that, so you only want your glue at the right hand side, so it, that will actually go behind. So I'm going to pop dimensionals on. My brain's not very good, so I want this side, so when it's back to front, it wants to be on the left side. And what didn't I do? I'm nearly out with my dimensionals. Needed to get a new pack out. Oops, that didn't cut off. Wherever it was, there. So, we're at this side. And I shall put that there. Oops. And that there. Just let me get another. Sorry, this is why I don't like to get dimensionals out. It rattles, the packets rattle. Come here. Well, doesn't want to come out. I've got one stuck. Never mind. I'll use them. Pop them away for later. Okay. So I'm just going to pop one down the bottom. Right. We're getting there, slowly but surely. To the side, so this needs to be on the right, so we're going to pull that out, place that down as best I can because I'm not right over it. I think it's straight enough. and then that is going to go behind there like so. Okay, so we've just got this little piece here that we're just going to sort next. Right, what have I done with it? So from the last celebration, I've still got some of this bedazzling. It's fabulous. So I thought I'd cut a bit of that out. We'll have a bit of bling. We like a bit of bling. So all I need is some basic white card. I'll use this, because what I need to do is stamp the Merry Christmas in real red, and then I'm going to die cut it out. So I have it with the ink pad ready. So the Merry Christmas is actually from, I think I'll put it away, For Unto Us. It's this little one there. It just fits nice in the circle die that I've got. So that's what we're using. And I always like to stamp the sentiment and then die cut it out. Because if I do the die cut, I'll not get the sentiment straight. So this is one of my tips. All right, if you get it right, if you're quite happy, but I'm terrible. So just tap, tap, tap into the ink. A little bit of pressure and pull up. Merry Christmas. And it'll soon be upon us. Do you know, you have everything to hand. It's right staring me right in front of my face. My chamois. Have everything to hand and then you can't find anything. And it's usually sat there looking at you. Okay, so that's the real red. And then the die cut is I've had this out tonight, can you tell? Well, that's my tags. Aha, I've covered it up. It's these little guys, and this is the Tasteful Labels dies. This is in the annual catalogue. And I only got them the other week, and I absolutely love them. So versatile. And the one I'm using is this big circle, and it's got a nice emboss around it. That's what I'm using. But you've got all sorts. You've got them with stitched edges. Some have stitched edges. Some have really nice, like, ornate lines. Like, these are embossed. These are all wiggly lines. It's lovely. Really nice, really good die set. Right, this is where I find I haven't stamped it right. Yes. There we go. I will use my mini machine tonight for this, so I don't have to get my big one out. This is so handy, just to chuck on your desk. So I'm just going to cut that so it will fit in my cut and emboss, or mini cut and emboss, should I say. Let's get it something like, and go with that, and then wind it through. That is the last of the die cutting, hopefully tonight. Plates away. And just before I take it out, I'll just show you. It's lovely. really pretty die cut. So when you take it out, you can either use that part and you've still got your dots and the fancy edge, and then you've got your fancy edge around that. It's lovely. It's really cool.
Right.
So what we're going to do here is pop that on there. I think I might go with tape, tearing tape. So a bit of tape on there. Come on, that's it. This is the only thing I find with tape. You get it stuck down, but it's taking the backing off. Faithful tweezers. Then I'm going to try and get it level. I don't. Okay, so then I pop this up on dimensionals. So we'll get the dimensional. What have I done with them? There we are. Staring at me. So pop this up on four dimensionals. In fact, I'll have one in the middle. So I'll just take that off. I say it's down to the individual. You can either stamp in the card or do a piece on the back. You could put a die cut on there with a sentiment, and you could write on the back. It's just down. It's down to the individual. So hang on. Can't see what I'm doing. So we're going to go somewhere like that. And because it's Christmas and I haven't done it on the other one, let's have some more bling. Okay. So, there is tonight's card. Oh, it's all blinged up. And then, I don't know if this will work or not, because I've got lights on, but I'm just going to take these lights off. And I've got a tea light. So, if that was stood up, so you can get the effect from the camera, you can see it all lit up. So it's cute. It's very cute. I did one year. It wasn't quite this style card, where I put a tea light in, and it was like the nativity scene. That was nice. But yeah, it just makes a nice little one to go on your mantelpiece with a tea light in. So that's that. But I haven't finished, purely because these die cuts here that we took out, we're going to make something else with it. We're going to make a tag. So we don't waste it, we just make more. So this little tag, so the grey is from the actual card. I just made another wreath. And out of Just trying to think which one it is. Out of Christmas to Remember. There's a Tis the Season stamp. And I've just stamped it in real red, cut it in half, popped it up in dimensionals. And there you go. I've just put some cut another real red tag the next size up. To and from. That's from Be Jolly stamp set. And put some twine. And that is your tag. So I can make, well, I can make four tags now. But yeah, it just shows you, you just, you know, don't waste it. Don't waste it. I've got some tags there to make. So, yeah, so that's what we've done. Oh, thank you, Sylvia. I'm glad to be back. I've got loads of, I love Christmas, and I've got a load of things going round in my head. So next week, I'm going to look at gift cards or money wallets, whichever you want. You could use for both. So that's what we're going to do. I'm going to do a couple of gift wallets. And then I've got some great little gift ideas for the couple of weeks after that. So I'm getting planned in my head. There's so much going on in there. It's I'm buzzing with all the excitement trying to get it all sorted and designed. But yeah, I just love crafting, and I love to share what I do. I love it. It's brilliant. So there we are. That is tonight. And I'll pop that down. There we go, so you can see what we've done. So, yeah, it's good to be back. Had a good weekend, as I said, with on stage making all the goodies and seeing all the new catalogue for next year and some lovely things, exciting things to come. So I'm really buzzing with it all. So, but thank you very much. I will put all the description, all the card sizes, scoring, everything like that, when I load it up to YouTube, in the description, everything will be there. So if anybody is interested for, you know, for the dimensions and everything, it'll probably be, it might be tonight, it might be tomorrow, it just depends on how I get on. But yeah, so anybody interested, they haven't got a demonstrator, if you drop me a line, I'll send your catalogue out. We have, as I said earlier at the beginning, we've got an excellent join Stampin' Up for £75. You can get £130 worth of product. You don't have to do any of this. You don't have to demonstrate. You can just do it if you do it as a hobby. You know, you can get the discount, because if you join, you've got to have a monthly, you've got to purchase so much a month to stay a demonstrator, but you have, it's done on a quarter. And if anybody's interested, just drop me a line. I can go through it with you. But it's at the moment, it's a fantastic offer till the 30th of November. Instead of being £99 and £130 worth of product, it's £75. So it's a great offer. So I think that's everything. Oh, and the sale, I'm just trying to think. Izzy did message me. Izzy did tell me. Just bear with us. Just let me have a look, just so I can. See you somewhere. She says. Can't find it now. 20% off dies anyway. Starting from tomorrow for a couple of days. It's 15% and 10%. One's off card, one's off inks. So if anybody's interested in joining, it's a fantastic, if there's, because you'll get your discount as well on your the sale stuff over the next couple of days. So yeah, I really enjoyed it. Thank you very much. You can tell I'm glad to be back. And I will see you next week, and we will be doing gift cards. Thank you very much for your time. If you're watching on catch up, I appreciate it. On if you're watching on YouTube, if you give me a thumbs up, I would love it. Subscribe to my channel would be lovely. And we'll see you next Monday for Monday Makes with me. Thank you very much. Bye.